Christmas time should be a time for family and friends to get together and appreciate one another. But for this family, divorce would sadly cause them to abandon their home in the middle of setting up Christmas decorations. This early 1900s home was lived in by a family of five and was left behind in the year 2015. Due to unknown circumstances, everything was unfortunately left behind inside of this home. Hopefully one day, the Christmas spirit will flow through this home again, but for now, it sits in silence. So let's take a look inside, and I want to say Merry Christmas to everyone, and a Happy New Year. What's up everybody, it is Big Banks. We're back again for another video. Today, we are exploring down in the south. This house that we are in right now, it's sort of like a random type place in the middle of a neighborhood, so we have to be a little bit quiet, but everything is left in here. It's a time capsule. This place was built in the early 1900s, owned by a pretty kind of middle-class family. Back in the day, this would have been considered like a mansion, but today's time, it's considered just a really big house. This place is beautiful. Everything's Southern style, beautiful architecture, and I want to show you guys everything in this place. It's absolutely amazing. I'm here with the Bandle fam, and I'm just going to get right into this video. We're going to try to find out a little bit more about it as we go along. And yeah, like I said, gotta be a little bit quiet because we're in a, you know, pretty busy neighborhood. So before we get into it, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and let's go.
All right, so before we actually get into the exploration, I want to show you guys this company right here, TryTreats.com. TryTreats.com is a subscription service that gets you different boxes full of different snacks from various different countries every single month. And they were kind enough to send me a box from Russia. So we're gonna do a little taste test right now. So I'm actually gonna give these two different a try right here. This chocolate bar and this little, it looks like chocolate with caramel in it. So we're gonna try that as well. Let's give it a try. Wow, it's very good. Like milk chocolate and like caramel inside. It's like a very thin layer of chocolate. So when you bite in, it's like, I don't know, it's very good. Let's try the baked chocolate bar. Feels like I'm Willy Wonka in the chocolate factory, ripping this thing open. Look at it, it's like gold. I've got the golden ticket here. And we have a big slab of chocolate right there. So let's just break off a piece. That's thick. Almost smells like a brownie, but we'll try it. Okay, it's like a thick, kind of flaky, dark chocolate. Tastes nice. Now that we've tried that, we have a lot more to go through and try as we go throughout our days. But just in time for the holidays, as you can see, you can go to TryTreats.com and get your own box today. Sign up and get a box from every country each month. And yeah, if you want to do that, use my code BIGBANKS at checkout for 15% off. And yeah, thank you TryTreats again for sending me this box. This stuff is absolutely amazing. So without further ado, let's get right into the video.
All right, so I'm gonna start you guys off in the living room. We've got two reclining chairs right here that have obviously been deteriorating for a little bit, or they've been cut open. I think maybe an elderly people sat here. And then they had a dog, obviously. Because there's this dog bed, and then there's another, like a little floral couch right here with another recliner. But in this room, getting into the architecture, we have very large windows. one, two, three, four, five different windows in here. And they're very large. They have these nice curtains still hanging up on them. The walls are purple, probably about 12-foot ceilings in here. And kind of just beautiful architecture. I like the purple. I like how these southern homes have different colors on all the walls. Then we have the fireplace. We have this, which was probably added on later on, but this is one of those little fireplaces right here. The mantle's pretty nice. That closet goes to the water heater. And then we have a TV right in this cabinet right here. So, that's pretty cool. Like I said, the living room is just pretty sweet. We have a carpet sling here in the middle of the floor. And we got some of this nice dark hardwood floors. They definitely had kids or grandchildren. Kids would be here quite often. There's quite a bit of toys left in this place. But there is no power. And then we have a pretty nice ceiling fan. It's kind of crazy that it's not like kind of warping or anything. I mean, because there's no moisture actually getting in here. There's a bottle of shells right here. Come back here. What do you think? What do you guys think this room's purpose was?
I think I need to be quiet.
This room right here?
Yeah.
Like a dining room, maybe? But yes. Like the kitchen's right here.
This is also larger than the living room, though.
Big bags, y'all.
Yeah, here's the Bando fam.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
But this is the largest room in here. It's larger than the living room, which is a little strange. Somebody's definitely been drinking some Coors Light. Have this old desk sitting here. Some of this old stuff here. What is this stuff? This looks like crystals. This room is really getting a lot of water damage. That's all black mold over there. And then the wallpaper in here is very pretty. I like it a lot. It's like blue and pink floral wallpaper. The kitchen's back there, so I'll take you to the kitchen next, and then we'll start going towards the bedrooms. Look at this whole thing. That's pretty. Pine cones in there. So, this room, I mean, there's a lot of stuff in here, but it's just kind of a little bit strange. So we are now entering the kitchen of this place, and it's got these nice cabinets up here. I actually really like these cabinets. All the spices and things are still in here. This stuff expired in 2005. A lot of this stuff did. Like everything is still left in these. Got the medicine part of it. Wow. Oh my gosh, that's nasty. A lot of Christmas stuff up there. Happy holidays. This is like all their holiday stuff here. Wow. Must have been around Christmas time when they left this place. got a nice bench here. You know it's the South when you see purses like this. We even have a little TV in here. You watch your cooking shows while you cook so you can learn how to cook. Someone has more glasses. Look at this. Just in time for the holidays, we have a big Santa Claus mug right here. That's great. I love how much holiday stuff is in here. Ew, that's old eggs. Those are real eggs too sitting in there. Kind of scary seeing all this stuff here, like this knife, things like that. Look at this. Tell me how many of you guys remember this. This is an old thermometer. To me, it always looked like fish were floating in there. That's really cool. I used to love these things. Obviously, there's probably food in here. Yeah, that's gross. That smells really, really bad. Oh my god, that's awful. Oh, I'm about to throw up. Oh. Oh my god, that's awful. Oh, jeez. I gotta cover my mouth. That's bad. Back this way, we have the laundry room. Look at all this OxyClean, bleach, things like that. Tons of clothes still in here. This is actually their old freezer, deep freezer, along with their washer and dryer right there. How can you leave all these clothes here? We have a bathroom right here. A lot of books in it. A ton of Stephen King books. That's all Stephen King books, or most of them. Dreamcatcher. Wow, really into Stephen King. Listen, all my viewers that are explorers, be really careful when you open fridges, because that left a really bad smell in here. So, I can still smell it. It's really bad. Bunch of rotten food, milk. Nasty, I just saw it. Ugh, bad. But I'm gonna show you the bedrooms now. So this is actually a back door. I think it was outside. There's like a little cool chandelier hanging here. But, okay, so they had a cat, for sure. Litter box. Food bowls. We're gonna go into the first bedroom here. This is what I believe to be the master bedroom. Tons and tons of shoes. More ladies' shoes than anything. More Stephen King books. We got the bed here. More clothes hanging up. That's from Belk. This can't be that old. I love how there's these carpets in here as well. A lot of these houses. Look at these Nikes. This can't be too old. Maybe like the latest, maybe 2015? I don't know, it's not that old. Obviously I'll blow this out, but implanted pacemaker identification card. So somebody has heart problems.
So somebody has a pacemaker.
Yeah. This is an implant date, 1979. I think so. There's another wallet. There's never money in the wallets. Wow. Pictures. Am I gonna show them though? There's a lot of Christmas stuff in here, man.
Yeah, I saw that.
A lot of Christmas stuff.
That's why I think they were abandoning it close to Christmas.
That's what I think too. It's just I haven't found an exact year to put it on yet. Let's walk around the side of the bed. We got more books. So she was really into reading. Like I said, especially Stephen King. There's a bunch of nail polish. Exercise bike. There's clothes hanging on it. Ironing board. There's even like a chest that's just full of fabrics and clothes and stuff. Right here we have a bathroom. It's really tight squeeze in here. Oh, we got the shower. I guess they brush their teeth in the shower. Toothbrushes there. All the bras and stuff is still here. I feel like maybe she lived alone for a while before she moved out. But what made her leave everything? Look at this brooch here. It's like a giraffe. Sparkly. Smells really, really bad. I don't know, it's just random stuff. And then right here is the hallway. We got the staircase, which I'll show you more of. Here's more Christmas decorations. I think this is gonna be my Christmas drop.
Yeah, this will be perfect for Christmas.
Look, there's even more Christmas decorations. Look at this staircase though, that's beautiful. Nice woodwork on it as well. I like the chandelier too. But guys, that's pretty much downstairs, so let's make our way upstairs and see what's left behind. So up here you can kind of see how pretty the staircase really is too. This little curvage, the woodwork, just absolutely amazing. But we are upstairs and our first room is right here and it is loaded. Absolutely loaded with stuff. Like, there's too much stuff in here. I could barely walk around. So much stuff. We've got a bowling ball, we've got a trumpet. We've got these boards, more Christmas decorations. They're in a marching band. There's a marching band suit in there. There's a Christmas tree. This is gonna be the Christmas episode, guys. Wow. They used to have a bird too. There's a bird cage back there. Punching bags. More Christmas decorations. What an incredible house. Just amazing how much stuff is in here. It's been so long since I've seen rollerblades. What the heck? Oh, there's a Nintendo down here. And a boat, RC boat. Wow, you don't see a lot of that. A globe here. Amazing. This room has like a shorter ceiling. That's blue. The woodwork on the doors is absolutely amazing. You can tell it's really decaying a lot. A lot of cracks in the ceiling as well. And over there. We go to our next bedroom. Which, I'm guessing a teenage boy lived in here. In this one. This is like your classical movie teenage boy's room. We got the bed. We've got the Bowflex here. It was a power booster, but whatever, you know what I mean. We got a speaker, so he was probably playing loud music while he worked out. And we got, I think this is an exhaust system for a car. He probably wanted to make his car really loud. Just so classic. Brake lines, like this kid was into cars. a lot. Some books and stuff in here, part of your school, graduation. Let's see that. Oh, this is his graduation thing, all of his whole thing. Maybe his, like, what to do and everything. Fake butcher knife. This is definitely your typical boys' room. He even had the workouts posted right here where you could see him when he was working out. Here's a closet. Oh my lord. Look at these vintage jackets. Auburn? Yo, these are vintage. I love that. Wow. Wow, that made my day right there. That's insane. I love that. This jacket right here is actually really nice. It's sitting on top of the speaker. It's from American Eagle. What size is it? It's a large. These are actually really nice jackets. I like those. Wow. You open up to these memories right here. That's amazing. There's even one with the run-in with the police. Oh, so he had a Mustang, it looks like. Mustang GT. That's pretty cool. So you know he was fond of his car. Come down the hallway. Come here to this big bedroom. Which is a much larger room. They really seem to like Auburn. We're not even anywhere near Auburn, which is crazy. I guess you either, when you're in Alabama, you either like Auburn or you like University of Alabama. Virginia is for lovers. I think this was a boys' room as well. Look at that, boxing gloves. Here's even a little airsoft gun there. Oh, I love this. This is a Hot Wheels collectible. A 1969 Corvette. That's nuts. Still in the box. But what's making it really weird is there's tons of alcohol. So maybe a squatter's been here. Looks like there's a ton of alcohol right here. And a ton of alcohol right there. Just everywhere. Coming here where Lacey is. To our final bedroom. What do you think's in here?
I don't really know. I feel like this is like another one of the kids' rooms, but
yeah,
she made some paintings.
I think this was like an all boys home.
Yeah.
Like I don't think they had any girls.
Yeah.
Because every room has like cars or like there's the workout room.
There's a lot of baseball stuff.
A lot of baseball. Now this cat here is really cool.
That's really cool. And they have these little exploding things.
And the alcohol.
Yeah.
The amount of alcohol in every room is a bit wild. They were all in high school, I think.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Whenever this was abandoned.
Yeah.
So much Christmas stuff, too.
For real?
The amount of Christmas stuff is blowing my mind.
What is that?
Fashion doll trunk. But that gives me girl vibes.
Yeah.
Whoa, it's full of Barbies. Yo, that's a Ken doll.
One is headless.
That's freaking Ken, yo.
We got another Ken.
There's so many Kens in here. We got casual Ken. We got beach Ken.
Beach Ken. Something on that was sticky.
That was very sticky. I better wash my hands.
Yeah, same. Oh. Okay.
Shin? Is it in there? Oh, it's Christmas decorations.
Well.
Ninja Turtles. Well, Auburn. Oh, yeah. Surprisingly, they have an Alabama hat in here, which is a little weird. Didn't think they would. Wow. Alright, Posey's got to show us something.
Maybe. I don't know. Hey. I used to be really good at it. Hold on, I think I have another one. Oh.
Ooh. It's probably a little old, you know?
Yeah, I think that's what it is. I used to be really good with a yo-yo.
So...
Hey, there was a girl.
There was a girl, okay. I think there's just one girl. I think the rest were boys.
Yeah.
Dude, I found my ex-girlfriend in his yearbook.
Really?
Like a girl I dated.
No way.
Yeah. It was like 1999 or something.
Wow.
So...
That's wild.
But they all went to the same school, apparently. He was friends with her sister and her. So.
Wow, that's crazy. Alright guys, well that's the end of today's video. We just explored this entire house. We love this house. Feel really bad that the owners had to leave it like this. And, you know, it just sucks seeing sad stories like that happen. And the reason all this stuff is left behind is usually because of maybe death or, you know, divorce, bad things. And we feel really bad for the people that had to go through that. So, we really enjoyed this house and we're gonna get out of here. Check out the Bando fam right here. And yeah, till next time, Big Banks out.